My heart, my mind, my soul belongs to you. You paid the price for me way back on Calvary. That's why I praise you, I lift you up, and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. For your spiritual sports segment on Rhema Gospel Radio, I'm CJ. For your quick news and notes, Bel Air is considering a date change for Eduardo Dantas' title defense after the champion was knocked out at Chuto Brazil 33 on August 25th. Abner Mares, who moved up in weight and won a vacant junior featherweight, will make his first defense against Anselmo Chimito Moreno, who also moved up in weight for the opportunity. Oscar De La Hoya told ESPNNewYork.com that he came close to ending his retirement and headlining the October 20th show at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York, against WBA middleweight champion Felix Sturm, but stated he's an old 39-year-old man. Middleweight contender Kid Chocolate Peter Quinlan, who only had 15 amateur bouts, now will fight for a world title as he will challenge title holder Hassan Ndjikim of France on October 20th at the new Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York. Andy Roddick, the 2003 U.S. Open champion and former number one ranked player, surprisingly announced his plans to retire at a news conference at Flushing Meadows on Thursday, his 30th birthday, and stated, quote, "I don't know that I'm healthy enough or committed enough to go another year," close quote. Brian Namoff, a former DC United defender, has filed a $12 million lawsuit against the team, and former coach Thomas Sohan sent a Russian back onto the field after the concussion that ultimately ended his career. Jorge Vergara and Angelica Fuentes have bought out former partners Antonio and Lorenzo Q, giving Vergara and Fuentes sole control of Chivas USA. IndyCar star Danny Sullivan and Supercross and Motocross great Ricky Johnson, along with drag racer Ed Pink, sports car driver Derek Bell, and late NASCAR star Neil Bonnet were inducted into the Motorsports Hall of Fame on America on Thursday night at the Fillmore Theater. In addition, the late Pop Dreyer was inducted in the historic category, and the late engine maker Vic Edelbrock Sr. was the at-large selection. Richard Petty Motorsports will remain a part of the Sprint Cup Series in 2013, despite a loss of manufacturer money and limited sponsorship, the car owner told ESPN.com. Carl Edwards addressed rumors that he was a candidate to drive the number 22 Sprint Cup car at Penske Racing in 2013 with a flat-out no during a Wednesday conference call. Number 3 LSU will go ahead with its originally scheduled start time of 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time Saturday for a season opener against North Texas, the university announced Thursday, as there was minimal damage to the stadium from Hurricane Isaac. Former Penn State assistant football coach Jerry Sandusky has been recommended for designation as a sexually violent predator, a legal status that would require lifetime registration with authorities. Recommendation? Please just make it official. A day after Alan Pinkett made some controversial comments about Notre Dame football, indicating that the team needs a little edge, but more importantly, he went too far with the criminal comments and was suspended for the school's game and possibly more against Navy in Dublin, Ireland. Purdue has dismissed senior linebacker Dwayne Beckford following his latest arrest and charged with 2 counts of possession of paraphernalia and 1 count of possession of synthetic drug stimulant from an August 20th incident. Linebacker Simeon Vihikaite is back with the USC Trojans after the jail stint and is back on scholarship after he was recently released from jail after being ordered in May to serve a year following a 2011 car accident in which he pleaded no contest to leaving the scene of an accident and driving at or above the legal blood alcohol content. Oklahoma State defensive coordinator Bill Young will miss Saturday's season opener against Savannah State after undergoing a medical procedure. Missouri freshman quarterback Maddie Mock has been arrested on suspicion of 4 charges, including leaving the scene of an accident after a scooter mishap. And finally, new Big East Commissioner Mike Aresco confirmed Thursday that the conference wants to add a 14th member for football and is planning to have a championship game after next season. This sports segment was sponsored by Naturally Relaxed Massage, where you can relax, release, and relieve naturally in the greater Houston area. Tune in next time for more updates on your next spiritual sports segment, where we sprinkle a little spirituality in your sports. I'm CJ. Be blessed and have a positive, productive, blessed day. And I leave you with namaste, as the divine in me salutes and honors the divine in you.